Okay. There are a few rules that you must obey while visiting the inmate. You will have 10 minutes to meet with the inmate. No passing objects, no passing unauthorized notes, no weapons of any kind, no smoking, no flammable substances, no prescription drugs,
keys,
no food, no pictures or video, no cell phone use, no recording devices, no pencils, pens, or other sharp objects that could harm the inmate or a guard. And finally, no physical contact. Okay, enjoy your visit to Desert Canyon.
Blue skies smiling at me. Nothing but blue skies do I see. Never saw the sun shining so bright. Never saw things going so right.
Wakey, wakey!
Business is good. God bless America. Now, you see what happens when you apply yourself? What am I always saying, people? You have to be proactive, like this guy. Take a page out of his book. Well done. Bluebirds singing a song. Nothing but bluebirds all day long.
Prisoner 687-303. Rise and exit yourself. You have a visitor.
Keep your visitor waiting. You never know when it's gonna be your last one ever. Let's go. Come on. Gentlemen?
Hola, papá. Gracias por verme. Me sorprendió que dijiste que sí después de tantos intentos. Traje los archivos de tu caso y unos papeles que tu abogada quiere que firmes. Muy importante. Dice que no le devuelves la llamada, que niegues a verla. ¿Por qué? ¿Qué haces? ¿Quieres morir?
Todos mueren.
Tengo un amigo en la escuela. Su padre es un gran abogado, no es un defensor público ahogando un papeleo. Hablé con él sobre tu caso y nos puede ayudar. Solo tienes que hablar con él. ¿Qué piensas?
¿Cómo está mi carro?
¿Tu carro? ¿Qué carajo te importa tu carro? Estoy hablando de tu vida.
Mi carro es mi vida. Trabajé mucho tiempo en él.
What are they saying?
They're talking about his car.
What?
Quieren poner una aguja en tu brazo. Este hombre te puede salvar, liberarte de una manera, darte otra oportunidad.
¿Una oportunidad para qué? ¿Qué piensas que haré diferente? ¿Ser un mejor padre? ¿Ir a ver un partido de pelota contigo? Fuera lo mismo afuera que acá adentro. Yo soy lo que soy. Lo mejor que hice fue alejarme de ti.
No voy a dejar de ayudarte. No puedo.
Trajiste lo que te pedí.
Me
Me fascinan los cigarros mexicanos. ¿Conoces el cuento del escorpión y la rana? Había un escorpión en la selva. Después de haber comido y matado todo lo que se le cruzaba en el camino, decidió encontrar un nuevo campo para cazar. A medio camino, el escorpión llegó a un río. Caminó arriba y abajo del río para encontrar un lugar seguro a donde pudiera cruzar. Pero no lo encontró. De repente, el escorpión ve una rana al otro lado del río. El escorpión le llama la atención y le pide su ayuda. Si lo ayuda a cruzar el río en su espalda, estaría eternamente agradecido. La rana le dice que no, que tan pronto el escorpión se suba a su espalda, lo picaría. El escorpión suplica y convence a la rana que necesita cruzar el río o morirá de hambre. Que si pica la rana cuando cruzan las aguas, los dos morirán. La rana considera la lógica de esto y acepta ayudar. Así la rana nada a través del río para ayudar al escorpión. El escorpión se sube a la espalda de la rana tan pronto que llega a la orilla del río. Los dos vuelven al agua. A mitad del río, la rana siente un dolor en la espalda. La rana mira hacia el escorpión y ve su cola perforando su cuerpo. ¿Por qué me estás picando? La rana preguntó. Ahora los dos moriremos.
¿Estás diciendo que yo soy la rana?
No. Todos son la rana. Los picaré a todos. Eso es lo que hago. Así que llévate esos papeles. Dile a los abogados que no esperen mi llamada. Tomaré cualquier castigo que me den. No vuelvas a este lugar. Olvídame. Déjame ahogar en el río.
It's a damn shame, kid, but that old man of yours is a monster, you know? He deserves everything that is coming to him. I'm just sorry. His blood runs through you.
Where are we going? So you do habla the English. Good. You see, I thought my friend here was going to have to translate for us, but this is better. You'll hear it straight from me. You're not going back to the cell block. In fact, you'll never have to see bars again. Vámonos. Did you know that back in the 1950s, before this was ever a prison, it was actually built as a fallout shelter? It's true. The government was so freaked out about the Red Scare that they built dozens of underground bunkers, including here at Desert Canyon. Eventually, the scare faded, of course, leaving all of these heavily fortified structures behind. So they figured they'd work as prisons. Over time, everyone forgot all about what lies beneath.
Wherever you're taking me, someone will come looking. No, I'm missing.
You'd be amazed at what a few strokes of a keyboard can do. You see, in here, you're just numbers in a computer, and this morning, I deleted you, so I can put you pretty much anywhere I want because you don't exist. Isn't that fun? I've done it before.
It was you. You ordered the hit. I was told by my employers that a jealous husband wanted his wife's ex-boyfriend to go away. Wanted it to be a big bang. And then your wife showed up.
And I was told that you were a professional. A flawless record, they said, that you make people disappear. Well, now I'm making you disappear. My way.
He was her lawyer, not her lover. She was gonna leave you. I watched them for weeks, never saw an affair. It only spoke by phone. And suddenly she shows up the day I strike. It felt wrong. When she called to him, he was surprised to see her. He rushed to her and saw something on her face. A bruise. You hit her. You made sure she'd run to him. He was consoling her, not caressing her. And then he did what you knew he would. He put her in his car.
You scared she was gonna call the feds? Tell them about what happens in this place? She knew your secrets. And so did the lawyer.
And so do you, which is why you're disappearing just like they did. I think I've heard about enough out of you. Let me show you your new home. Oh, and I think you'll be glad to know that you'll be safe down here, as I have the only set of keys. Now it's time to say goodbye. There it is. The deluxe suite. Yeah. I think you're gonna be very happy. What the fuck are you doing?
My job, cabrón.
Okay, give me that thing. No!
Just breathe.
Why?
He had a debt to pay. You paid the commission for one kill, not two. That debt must be paid.
Okay. I'll pay more. I have money.
Oh, we know. That wasn't your money to take.
You'll never make it out of here. You can't just walk out.
Actually, I can. I'm just a number that you deleted. Remember? Besides, I was just visiting.
Me fascinan los cigarros mexicanos.
Keys, Warden.
Oh, and, one more thing.
You can't be serious. Come on. We can... You can't be serious! I did what was asked of me. I hope this puts things right with the commission.
Your debt is paid. No more card games for you.
Yeah.
Get off my car. The glasses, nice touch.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, they're my dad's. Hey, man, that was fun. We should do it again. Can I be the inmate next time? Maybe you could be like my uncle or something?
Yeah, sure, kid.
So what's next, boss?
We go see the Hawk. Debts are owed. It's our job to collect.
To get the fatty like that, throw any